Hello students, today we will discuss about law of diminishing marginal utility. First, we will understand what is utility, total utility, marginal utility. Utility is the want satisfying power of a good or service. Here, utility measures satisfaction. The total utility means the total satisfaction received by a consumer from consuming all the units of a good or service. The marginal utility of a good or service is the utility gained from an increase in the consumption of that good or service. In other words, marginal utility is the additional or incremental satisfaction a consumer receives from acquiring one additional unit of a product. Now, we will understand the person who is responsible for the introduction of the law of diminishing marginal utility. The law of diminishing marginal utility has universal applicability and applies to all the goods and services. This law was first given by a German economist H.H. Gossen in 1854. That is why it is also known as Gossen's first law of consumption. Later, it was systematically developed and popularized by Alfred Marshall. In the slide, you find the Alfred Marshall's picture and H.H. Gossen's picture. Now, we'll understand what is the definition given by Alfred Marshall. According to Alfred Marshall, the additional benefit which a person derives from an increase of his stock of a thing diminishes with every increase in the stock that he already has. Here we can understood that the additional benefit, that is marginal utility, which is derived from a consumer from consuming additional unit, which will be decreases as consumer goes on consuming a units of the commodity. Therefore, we can say that the law of diminishing marginal utility says that the utility will be diminishes as the consumer consuming the additional commodities. Before going to the theory of law of diminishing marginal utility, first we will understand the law of diminishing marginal utility. That is, as a consumer consumes more and more units of a specific commodity, utility which is derived from the successive units goes on diminishing. That is, in making choices, most of the people spread their incomes over different kinds of goods. People prefer a variety of goods because more and more of any one good reduces marginal satisfaction derived from the further consumption of the same good. And this law expresses an important relationship between utility and the quantity consumed of a commodity. The law is based on certain assumptions. The law of diminishing marginal utility operates under certain specific conditions. Economists call them as assumptions of this law, which includes, first one is cardinal measurement of utility. Here we can say that utility can be measured in terms of numbers. For example, a consumer can say that 25 utils of satisfaction from eating a bowl of ice cream, while someone else would only get 5 utils of satisfaction. Thus, it is assumed that utility can be measured and a consumer can express his satisfaction in quantitative terms such as 1, 2, 3, etc. The second assumption says that monetary measurement of utility. Here we can say that utility can be measured in monetary units by the amount of money consumer is ready to sacrifice for another unit of commodity. Third, it is consumption of reasonable quantity. It is assumed that a reasonable quantity of the commodity is consumed. For example, we should compare marginal utility of a glass full of water and not spoonful of water, because if a thirsty person is given water in a spoon, then every additional spoon will yield him more utility. So to hold the law true, suitable and a proper quantity of the commodity should be consumed. Fourth, it is there must be a continuous consumption. It is assumed that consumption of a commodity is a continuous process. A person must be consume the commodity one after the other. Suppose if one ice cream is consumed in the morning and another in the evening, then the second ice cream may provide equal or higher satisfaction as compared to the first one. Therefore, it is assumed that there must be a continuous consumption. Fifth one is, there is no change in quality. The quality of the commodity which is consumed must be uniform, because a second cup of ice cream with the nuts and toppings may give more satisfaction than the first one. If the first one was without nuts and toppings, therefore the quality must be uniform, as well as there must be constant in quality. Sixth, it is consumer is rational. The consumer is assumed to be a rational, which means he will measures, calculates and compares the utilities of different units of the commodities, and he wants to aim at maximizing total satisfaction. So that here the law is assumed that the consumer is rational. Seventh, it is independent utilities. It is assumed that all the commodities which are consumed by a consumer are independent. It means marginal utility of one commodity has no relation with the marginal utility of other commodity. Further, it is also assumed that one person's utility is not affected by the utility of the other person. Therefore, we can say that it is independent utilities. Eighth, it is marginal utility of money remains constant. As a consumer spends money on the commodity, he is left with lesser money to spend on the other commodities. In this process, the remaining amount of money becomes dearer to the consumer, and it increases the marginal utility of money for the consumer. But such an increase in marginal utility of money here is ignored, because as marginal utility of a commodity has to be measured in monetary terms, it is assumed that marginal utility of money remains constant. The last one is fixed income and prices. The law of diminishing marginal utility also assumed that income of the consumer and prices of the goods which the consumer wishes to purchase are remains constant. With this, we can say that in this class we have studied the meaning of the utility, total utility, marginal utility, and the theory of the law of diminishing marginal utility, as well as we have also studied the assumptions of the law of diminishing marginal utility. Today we will wind up the class and we'll move on to the next class in the next session. Thank you.